Hey, what's going on? Happy Thursday, everybody. I actually have the white ink issue resolved. The trick is, and I learned this on a forum, is to go from 12 passes to 24 passes. And I'll show you the results. Watch this. So this was the 12 pass print that I showed the other day, where as you go further down, you start to see banding. There it is. See it. Now here's the 24 pass. Smooth like butter. Flexi is not capable of powering this machine with white ink and clear. It's a bug in the system, doesn't even recognize the ink that's in there. And so color profiling and Flexi with this ink setup we have is just not possible right now until Flexi fixes the issue. So they have a bug request on that. But in the meantime, we're having to run the flatbed via Rasterlink. And my staff hasn't been trained on it yet. We have been printing the color side of things in Flexi. Now, one thing that we've noticed even before we did the ink swap was that our inks were not drying well. And the issue apparently is Flexi is not properly exposing the ink to the UV lights. And because we're running this in Rasterlink and it works absolutely beautifully. Honestly, I would use Rasterlink for every single one of my Mamaki machines because I'm a 100% Mamaki shop, but for some reason, my Mamaki tech doesn't know how to color profile inside of Rasterlink. And so, and can only color profile in Flexi. So, and the color profiles for the JV100s in Rasterlink are straight garbage. So I can't use it. Anyways, UV, the clear. I have not done anything with clear yet. And I just did this one project. Take a look at some of the footage of it getting printed. Here's the entire boards. So it's an 8-foot by 16-foot mural that we're gonna be hanging. We're doing a lot of these. There's one of these going in every single school in our county. So in our county school system anyways, but it's so shiny, so clear. I freaking love it and it looks so, so good. You guys remember this? Yeah. It's been a month already. For those, just if you didn't watch the first video, I did a completed projects log book because I determined that we need to make $2,400 a day. We need to complete $2,400 worth of projects a day in order to cover all of our expenses for the month of May. And so I broke everything down and I did this to keep our whole team on track, to keep our whole team informed, and it went pretty good. So here's the results. So just to give you guys a little flavor, here's what the days kind of look like. I got it broken down by different categories. I put the total that we did that day, and you can see this is what we need to reach. And so our loss for that day was 1,867. Loss of 656, loss of 1928, loss of 2003. Then we start getting into some positive territories and make up some ground. There's days where there's literally nothing gets done because we're doing very large projects, perf installs, and we don't finish it. This is only for completed projects. And we don't really do The only thing that gets considered completed is if it's ready to be picked up by the client, and if it's an install, if it's ready to be installed, or not if it's ready to be installed, if it is installed. And so we really stuck to our guns with this thing. And on the first page, I have this tally, and you can see for the month, I really needed to hit 52,800 in completed projects, and we did $66,004. So yeah, we have a lot of negative days, but we have a lot of positive ones as well. And the positive ones are usually quite large. This is a good exercise. I'm going to keep doing this. Number one, it's a trigger for whenever a project is completed, our team members go to our customer service person and say, hey, this job's completed. Customer service person is in charge of logging them in here. They're in charge of making sure it gets invoiced. They're in charge of making sure the client gets called to pick up their project. Because before we had a customer service rep, sometimes projects would sit there a while just because we were just a little bit busy trying to, get other projects done. But it's important to keep that cash flow rolling. This isn't like a real look at finances or cash flow or anything like that. Some of these projects we received down payments for in the previous month. So not necessarily a really good tool for keeping track of your finances at all. So that's not what this is. This is more about making everybody on the same page about what we need to accomplish every day for the entire month. So yes, I'm gonna make a new one of these for the month of June, and we'll see how June goes. I'm a little stressed out right now, to be honest, guys. I have probably $100,000 worth of perf to install by June 15th, or the projects just get canceled. Also, I have all of these to install in, like, I don't know, it's like 10 different schools that we have to install these things for. So by June 15th. So we are under the gun here. We are literally going to, I hate saying literally, we are going to, we're telling all clients we're 3 weeks out on anything right now. So if you need it like today or tomorrow or in the next couple weeks, I'm sorry. We have way too much going on to get it done. So we just got to do what we got to do. I appreciate you guys tuning in. I'm going to leave this video at that because this is a lot. And if I do anything else today, I'll make it into another one. You guys have a great one, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.